राम 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 जानकी कांत स्मरणम
जय जय राम राम
नमः पार्वती पतये
महादेव
सर्वत्र गोविंद नाम संकीर्तनम
गोविंद गोविंद
सद्गुरु महाराज की
जय
भगवान के पावन नाम की
जय
अखिल कोटि साधु संतुलकु
जय
गणेशादि सकल देवता मूर्ति की
जय
पुंडलीक वरदा आंजनेय स्वामी की
जय
सदाशिव समारंभम शंकराचार्य मध्यमा अस्मत् आचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरा अमल रजत देकं भाति चिज्योति देकं हृदय कुखर मध्ये निष्कलं देवरूपं निकटपथि विचारैर्वृत्तिभिः सादरेण सभयमभिवरेण्यं तेजसा दीप्यमानं कर्णतनुधियां यत्प्रेरकस्वेन भासा कबलितजगद्दण्डपिण्डमध्ये शयानः सकल हृदय वास शाश्वतो ब्रह्मरूपो वितरतु परिशुद्धिं चेतसो नशिवाख्यः सुधा सिंधु समुद्भूत शीतांशुरुचिर प्रभा संध्यारंभ सुवर्णाभ नाटकेश्वर विग्रहं महादेव समायुक्त चिदानंदमयीं शिवा मनो मंदिर कंजातन भासमानो समाश्रये सर्वकल्याणदातारं सर्वापद्घनवारकम् अपार करुणामूर्ति आञ्जनेयं नमाम्यहम् सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की
जय
श्री ज्ञानेश्वर पंडरीनाथ महाराज की
जय
अलंकापुरी पुण्य भूमि पवित्र तिथे नांदतो ज्ञान राजा सुपात्र तयाठविता महा नमस्कार माजा सद्गुरु श्री ज्ञानेश्वरासी ओम नमो जियाद्या वेद प्रतिपाद्या जय जय स्वसंवेद्या आत्मरूपा देवा तुचि गणेशु सकलार्थ मति प्रकाशु मणे निवृत्तिदासु अवदा कौतुकया ज्ञानदीप नमो सद्गुरु सच्चिदानंद रूप नमो सद्गुरु भक्त कल्याणमूर्ति नमो सद्गुरु भास्करा
ध्यान
सुख जाने वो सागर Sadhguru's immense grace is falling incessantly on all of us.
because of which every day becomes a good day. What is a good day? A day when everything that we wish for happens, comes true. Is that a good day? It might seem to be a good day to us, but Mahatmas say it's not quite a good day. Then what is a good day? When nothing bad happens to us, will that become a good day? No. The answer is again, no. When we are safe, is that a good day? No. Then what makes a good day? The great saints of our land say that a good day is when Ramu Dinam Modinave Sudinam Ramu Dinam Modinave Sudinam Rama. Should we take that out of love? Should we take that when in fear of death? Should we take that as a mere spiritual practice? The great saints say that whichever way you take Rama's name, that day is Sudinamu. Preeti life has become meaningful. That is the day the purpose of our life is completely attained. Artha puja to Lord with golden flowers, with own free hands, that day is indeed a great day. Karamuna So every day becomes a good day to worship the Lord. Every day, the day when we take the name of Lord, that becomes a good day. However, there are some days of the year which are said to be especially propitious, especially auspicious, and to be set aside for Hari Bhajanam. If we take the lunar phases, we have 2 lunar phases a month. So if we take the lunar phases, the 11th day, the 11th Tithi, that day, which is known as Ekadashi, the Ekadashi day is said to be especially good for worshipping Bhagavan. In fact, that day is called as Haridinam, a day meant to be dedicated entirely to Hari. Spiritually, the saints of our land have given great importance to Ekadashi. Especially in all Vishnu temples of India, Ekadashi is of primary importance. In Pandharpur, out of all Ekadashis, 4 Ekadashis are very important. They are Ashadi Ekadashi, Kartiki, Magh, and Chaitra. These 4 Ekadashis are of primary importance. The Ashada Ekadashi that we celebrate in Pandharpur especially, this Ekadashi is called as Sarva Shayane Ekadashi. This is the Ekadashi where we put the Lord to sleep in the ocean of milk. So just like how we do Dolotsavam to Bhagavan in Sampradaya Bhajana, this Ekadashi is the day when Bhaktas believe that Bhagavan goes to rest. He goes to Yoga Nidra. And we wake him up after 4 months. So after 4 months comes Kartiki Ekadashi. So this Kartiki Ekadashi is the Prabodhini Ekadashi where we wake up Panduranga. All Ashadi Ekadashis are therefore days of great celebrations. In fact, a typical Wari would come to about 20 days where people come from Dehu, from Alandi or from their respective villages by foot. They sing and dance the names of God. They come to Pandharpur, have Bhagavan's darshan and go back. This is the root of Varakari Sampradaya. However, in the present situation, we are in a place where most of us can't think of taking a Vari. So in English, we have a common phrase which says, if the Muhammad cannot go to the mountain must come to Muhammad. Therefore, we are leaving Panduranga with no other option but to come to us because we are not in a position to go to him. And hence, this satsang, Panduranga Ere, is an open and an earnest invitation to Panduranga to come and dance in the brick that is inside all our hearts. And therefore, with open hands, with soulful hearts, let us implore, let us invite Panduranga right into our hearts. Panduranga
Yeah.
Hearts, because this is a Lord who has a proven record of running to whichever bhakta who calls him with an open heart. Why did Krishna, who is a Dwaraka Natha, why did he come to Pandaripuram in the first place? Because he was so curious, so inquisitive to see someone doing such a sincere bhakti or devotion towards his own parents. And that is why the Dwarakadisha came to Pandaripuram to see how Pundalika is doing bhakti to his parents. And upon the request of this devotee, Panduranga stood here forever to give darshan to any devotee who comes to see him. This Vari Yatra that we were talking about is therefore a visit to see that Lord who is the king of all the bhaktas. No matter which devata, whoever has bhakti to God, Panduranga is for him. He stands with an open heart, with his hands on the waist, eagerly awaiting all the devotees who come to see him. And who was the first one to do this Vari? The first one to do this Vari is none other than Adinatha himself. The Adinatha who is Lord Parameshwara. That is why for Varakari Sampradaya, Lord Parameshwara is called the first Guru, Adinatha. We sing,
Adinatha Guru Sakala Siddhancha Machindra Tayacha Mukhya Shishya Machindra Ne Bodha Goraksha Sikela Goraksha Bolale Gagini Prati Gagini Prasada
So this is the Guru Parampara Abhang, where we list all the Gurus from Adi Deva to Machindranath to Gahini Nath to Nivriti Nath to Jnaneshwar Mavali. So this is the Parampara that we remember when we do a Vari, because it is that very Lord Parameshwara as cited in the Grantha Pandari Mahatmya, where it is said that the first Bhagavan to do a Vari himself is Lord Parameshwara. And this Parameshwara, the Lord, the route that this Parameshwara had shown himself in one Abhangam, Jnaneshwar Mavali says, Pundalika has given us this Marga and we are joyously taking this great Vari. And Jnaneshwar Maharaj says, do not think that the road to Pandaripuram is just a road. No, it is Vaikunthicha Marga. It is the very route to Vaikuntham itself. And this Bhakti Marga, this path of devotion, that is so easy. There is no sadhana, no difficult penance to do. But the sadhana itself is so sweet that you hardly realize when your destination has come. It is as sweet as this. Bhakti Marga Fukata. It is such an easy path, and this path of happiness, Ananda Shipak way, this has been given to us by Pundalika himself. Lagali says away Pundalika. As bhaktas dance and sing happily, Dindi, Tala, Ghola, Garuta Kyanche Bhara, with flags in their hands, with talam, with all the merriment, as they march towards the town of Pandari, the entire town reverbs with that Jayakara, Vaishnavache, Gajara, Jiye Nagari. And therefore, as Jnanadeva is himself taking this Vari, as he is taking this Vari along with his Gurudeva and his elder brother, Nivriti Nath, Jnaneshwar Maharaj is telling to his brother, his Guru, what a big fortune Pundalika had that Bhagavan himself came all the way from Dwaraka to see him. What a bhagya, what a bhagya. Remembering this, all bhaktas take the name of Jnaneshwar Mavali and Tukaram Maharaj. This is the path, you know. All Mahatmas, they do not claim for themselves. They do not say, this has been invented by me. This has been patented by me. This is a technique invented by me. No. All Mahatmas say that this is the route that all our rishis have traveled, all our great sages have traveled exactly the same route, and we are just showing you that path. We are not talking about anything new here. This is the lakshana of a good sampradaya. There is no technique here. There is no patented method involved here. No, there is no quick way out here at all. the lakshana of a good sampradaya is that it says it has been given to us by sages, and we have a great parampara to talk about. And therefore all the bhaktas, even now, so what do we do? When Jnaneshwar Mahavali was singing the glory of Pundalika, we bhaktas marched towards Pandari singing the glory of Jnaneshwar Maharaj and Tukaram Maharaj. All these mahatmas have shown us the very path of devotion through this Vari Yatra.
Jnanoba Mahavali Tukaram, Jnanoba Mahavali Tukaram, Jnanoba Mahavali Tukaram, Jnanoba Mahavali Tukaram, Jnanoba, 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 Jnanoba Tukaram, Jnanoba Mahavali Tukaram.
He would have sung Panduranga re, Panduranga re, Panduranga re, Vithoba re. Whether he sang or not, Of course, I think Panduranga came uninvited to Pundalika. In fact, Pundalika even said, please wait, I am not ready enough to receive you, and put two bricks for him, for the Lord to stand outside the house while Pundalika is doing service to his parents. But there was a king who called Panduranga, gave him an open invite. Panduranga ere. And this Bhagavan, he went along with the king. This was the great king of a place called Vidyanagara. It is also known as Vijayanagara, which happens to be in the present day Hampi. So this king of Hampi, he is a staunch Devi devotee, Devi Upasaka. He had built a very nice mandapa, a huge temple for Devi, and had a simhasana made out of pure gold on which he used to seat this Devi and did Nitya Puja. Until one day, a Brahmin came from Pandharpur. So this king was talking to the Brahmin about their upasanas, and he was talking how great his Devi is. He went to the extent of telling that the grandeur of Devi is so much superior to your Panduranga. Now this irked the Brahmin. Now the Brahmin said, he's talking to the king, but he got so passionate when he's talking about his own Devata, Panduranga. He said, O king, haven't you seen Pandharipuram? This entire place, Pandharipuram, there is not a place where you can find ordinary sand or ordinary stone. The entire place has just gold and precious metals, precious stones, nothing less than that. In fact, the entire town just glistens because it is having so many precious jewels. The king is like in total disbelief. How is this possible? Now the Brahmin tells one more thing. The Raja is the name of the Devi whom the king is worshipping here. So this Brahmin tells, you know what? This Rajai who you worship here, she is a sweeper there in our town. You come and see for yourself. Now the king has no second thought. The king calls everyone, come here, we are going to Pandharipuram, pack your bags. So the entire sena now marches forth to Pandharipuram. The king is coming with elephants, with horses. No, king can't travel light. They come with a huge following. So they are now coming to Pandharipuram. And the king is telling, see Brahmin, if what you are saying is not true, you will have to face the grunt of it. Are you really sure that the kingdom, the place is as per your description? Are you really sure? The Brahmin thinks of Panduranga firmly in his heart and he says, yes, it is true. In Mahabhakta Vijayam, Mahipati Baba pauses here to tell that, oh devotees, this is indeed true. This statement is 100% true, because for a devotee, any place of his Ishta Devata is indeed a place of gold, and there is nothing less than that. So here, the Brahmin again reconfirms what he said, and he said, yes, it is true. You can come and see for yourself. And now they are on their way to Pandharpur, and as they reach the outskirts of Pandharipuram, it's early morning. Raja can't wait to see this. So you know what he does? He climbs on one of the elephants. They're coming with a huge army. So the Raja climbs on the elephant to see the spectacular sight for himself. And indeed, yes, he is seeing a town full of gold. And he can see the Gopura, which is glistening with gold. So much of shining that he can hardly open his eyes and see that place. He can't open his eyes fully to see the temple. He is awestruck. Raja now gets down the elephant. He falls on the Brahmin's feet. He says, you opened my eyes. I do indeed see a place of grandeur. Now I can't wait to see the Lord of Pandharpur. Please take me. And therefore, the Brahmin along with the king, they're now in the queue waiting for darshan of Panduranga. Now, as they are waiting, you know, when we are a new place, we would be all eyes and ears around to see the people, observe what they're doing. So here, the Raja, as he is going, he sees a lot of beautiful women. They're all cleaning, doing seva here. So Raja asks this Brahmin, who are these ladies? And the Brahmin replies, you know, this lady who is mopping there, she's Ramba. And this lady who is dusting off the cobwebs, she is Tilotama. And this lady who is wiping the lamps clean, she is Urvashi. Raja is asking, they are the Apsara Stris, right? And Brahmin says, yeah, they are. You know, because all these women, the only stories we know are when they are in proper uniform. They are near their corporate entity because they have a purpose to achieve. So they are all well dressed. But here, they are in their own homes. Like, for instance, if we take air hostess, you know, they are in properly dressed when they are in their duty. But at their in their homes, they may not be so well dressed. They will be in their comfortable wear, right? Just like that, all these Apsara Kanyakas, they are here in their Mahera, their own hometown. So they are all in their easy wear, but they are dashing, they are looking gorgeous still, and they are cleaning, sweeping, wiping the lamps, tying garlands for the Bhagavan. Raja can't behold this sight. And one lady is sweeping. This lady looks very familiar to Raja. And he doesn't have to ask this Brahmin who this lady is. The Raja knows her very well. She is Rajai herself. The very Devi who Raja is doing puja unto. So Raja goes and falls straight at her feet and he asks her, O Devi, O Rajai, I have been giving you the best of my services in my kingdom in Vidyanagara. I have been offering you the best of Naividyam, putting you on a golden throne. Why are you here sweeping the floor, not just of Pandharpur Kshetra, but of the entire town? So Rajai replies, yes, my son, you have been doing puja to me, but that is different. Here, I am here in my brother's place and I have every right to do service to him. Now, the Raja gets a thought. Mind is a very tricky thing, you know. We think we have reached some place in our sadhana, but it will come down. One single thought and everything just comes down. Until now, Raja was in a great bhava of bhakti. Now Raja has a thought. All these days, I have been watering a leaf, forgetting the entire tree. Which means, this Devi is nothing. And Panduranga is way up this Devi. Therefore, I should ditch this Devi and I should now start doing puja to Panduranga. This Dvandva Bhavam is a great menace to all sadhakas. You know, this is just, even if we take this as a story, this thought of dualship, this is separate, that is separate. And if we see one devata, nothing, and another devata as everything, our bhakti is not pure. You know, we have a lot of devatas, especially in Sanatana Dharma, we don't have just one saguna rupa, we have many rupas. There are two approaches. We can see everything as one. If my Ishtadevata is Rama, even if I go to a Devi temple, I see just Rama there and I do namaskara thinking of Rama, thinking that Devi is also Rama. If we can't do worship, if we can't do bhakti like that, then we should pray to that Devata that, O Devi, please give me devotion so that I can do more bhakti towards Rama. This is how Samartha Ramadas prays to Saraswati Devi. Demaja Divyamati Saraswati Demaja Divyamati Rama Katha Bhagu Goda. Yeah. Devi, give me power so that I would be able to recite the names of Lord Rama, sing his glories in full force. This is how Samatha Ramadasa prays to Saraswati Devi. So we can have devotion to one God, but it should never be at an expense of another, right? So here, now Raja feels that Panduranga is so superior to Devi. Now Raja thinks, that's a Kshatriya Rakta, no? He wants to own everything that he likes. So Raja tells Panduranga, now pack your bags and you are coming with me. Panduranga ye re, Panduranga ye re. So Panduranga says, I can come with you, but on two conditions. First condition, you should not keep me anywhere while you're going. If you keep me somewhere, I would stay there. Like how Sri Ranga placed a condition to Vibhishana, right? So that is the first condition. And the second condition, after you take me to Vidyanagaram, if there is any apachara, any insult caused to any of my devotees, any of the Vaishnavas, then I shall not stay with you any longer. Are you in agreement to this? So terms and conditions placed. Raja nods, yes. And so a big modus operandi is placed. Without any saints knowing about this, Raja has his soldiers lined up on both sides on the way they are traveling, and they take Panduranga. No one comes to know about this, and Raja takes Panduranga to Vidyanagara, builds a temple where no one is aware of, and he installs his deity there and he does puja. There is only one pujari there to help him, and there is no one else who even know that there is such a deity there. No one knows about it. This continues until one Ashada Ekadashi, all the varis are coming to have darshan of their Lord. When they come, they are coming to Pandaripuram and they see the main shrine empty. That is when everyone realizes Panduranga isn't here. Then everyone search high and low. Where is Panduranga? Where is Panduranga? Someone says a lot of philosophy saying, let's see Panduranga everywhere. There is no meaning searching for him. Many others cry out loud in sorrow. Where is my Lord? Where is my Lord? One devotee sees all these things for some time and he can't stand it any longer. And that devotee is Maharaj Bhanudas. Who is Bhanudas? Bhanudas Maharaj is the great grandfather of Eknath Maharaj. So Bhanudas can't stand this drama any longer. He says, enough is enough. We have to find where Panduranga is. And he inquires and he finds somehow that Panduranga is in Vidyanagara under the custody of this king. So Bhanudasa, without a second thought, he goes to Vidyanagara. He goes there and somehow he finds out the place where Raja has hidden Panduranga. He goes there at night when Raja isn't there. He finds Panduranga there and gives him a strong hug onto his feet. And Bhanudasa cries out loud, oh Lord, how could you stay here without seeing us? One king invites and you come over here so quickly. Are you so fickle-minded, O Lord? He asks. Panduranga also starts crying. He says, it took you so many days to find me out and come here. I have also been waiting here to see you all. What took you so long? And that night long, the Bhakta and the Bhagavan engage themselves in dear conversations. It's a beautiful passage in Bhakta Vijayam where there are intimate conversations between the Bhakta and the Bhagavan. Bhagavan can't wait any longer to see the Bhakta. The Bhakta can't wait any longer. And they are in a deep state of happiness. They talk to each other. They scold each other. They love each other. They kiss each other. They hug. And it's early dawn. And now Panduranga says, you can go have your bath and come. Early morning, the king would come. The king Ramaraya, he would come here. And before him, you can express your love to me and I will come with you. So Bhanudasa also nods, yes, my Lord. Panduranga is now so much overcome with his love. He takes a Navratna necklace from his neck and he puts it on Bhanudasa. This is the naughtiness of the Lord. He could have sent him just like that. Which saint longs for a Navratna necklace? I don't know. But this is how naughty Panduranga is. And Bhanudasa goes to have a bath. And he's there doing japa after taking a bath. Meanwhile, King Ramaraya, he comes. He's a king, so he has a knife for everything that's precious. So Ramaraya, the moment he opens the door of Panduranga's shrine, the first thing that he sees is that the necklace, he has many necklaces. The king has adorned the Lord with a lot of precious necklaces. First thing the Raja sees is that the Navaratna necklace is missing. He immediately calls the Pujari. Where is that necklace? It was here when I did Dolotsava the previous night. Where is it gone? Pujari says, you never let me have a glance at Panduranga, so I never knew in the first place that there was a Navaratna necklace. Now, the king says, this is a serious crime. Someone has found out the place where Panduranga is worshipped and someone has stolen a necklace. How dare he does that? He calls all his soldiers and he asks them to search high and low and bring in that robber. So all the soldiers are now searching high and low, and one of them find that along the shores of the river, there is Bhanudasa who is fresh after taking a bath. He has adorned himself with gopi and all the Vaishnava Lakshanas. He is having a nice tulsi bead. He is sitting there and doing japa. And on his neck, there is a Navaratna necklace. Now soldiers catch him red-handed. They say, you are the thief who has come to steal the Lord's necklace, and they drag him to the king. Bhanudasa doesn't know how to respond. So Bhanudasa just goes along with him. All the way, Bhaktas, the people in the kingdom, they speak this and that. How can he do this? Such a big crime he has done. And that too coming from another place. He has come from Pandharpur and done this crime. Unbelievable. They're talking to each other. And they drag Bhanudasa to the king's palace. Now the king says, how dare you come and steal the very Lord's necklace? And therefore, a punishment of the highest order will be placed on you. And the punishment is that you will have to be torn apart by a spear, a trishulam. So this is a very cruel punishment, where they have a big trishula, a spear there with spokes on it, and the body will be placed on it, and this trishula will literally tear apart the body while the body comes down. So it's a very cruel sight to even see this being done. But Bhanudasa is firm. He has no conscience prick, because he hasn't done anything wrong. In his heart, he talks to Panduranga. Oh, Panduranga, is this your way? Is this the way you do mercy unto your devotees? Very nice, Panduranga. Even if you do that, I will take it gladly as your prasada. I am not going to ask you for any mercy on me. Don't think I will do that. If this is thy will, so shall it be. And therefore, he stands there bravely facing this cruel punishment. Now the soldiers, they lift Bhanudasa and they place him on the spear, the trishula. They are placing him on the spokes. As they do this, you know, Bhanudasa is just seeing the blue sky on top, and again he is just filled with remembrance of Bhagavan, who is Neelamegha Shyamala, thinking of that God who is in the same complexion as the sky. He is still in Panduranga Dhyana. As his body touches that spear, it turns into a lush green tree. And wherever his body is touching, there are thick and soft flowers there holding him tight. Now all see this wonder. The king himself is seeing this wonder of that trishula, that spear turning into a tree and holding Panduranga, holding Bhanudasa. The king now realizes that Bhanudasa is not a thief, but he is a very dear devotee of Lord Panduranga. Now enters Panduranga. Until now he was silent. Now Panduranga comes to say to the king, O king, the second condition that I had placed to you is now broken. I had asked you that none of my devotees should be done any wrong. And if that is the case, I shall leave this place. So, O Bhanu, pack your bags. Come, let's go back to Pandharpur. And the very Lord now transforms himself to a small vigraha and hops in into Bhanudasa's jolnapai, that bag that all these devotees carry. This is that very Lord in Ashtapati, when he was with his father, he was a small baby, an infant Krishna. When he sees Radha, he just changes the entire atmosphere. There are thick clouds and he acts as if he's so scared. And Nanda Baba gives his baby to Radha Rani, asking her to take him safely home. As soon as Nanda Baba turns and he's gone, now the small infant, he is turning into a beautiful, a handsome Sukumara, right? And now he is having Rasa Krida with Radha Rani. How did he change? It's all Bhagavan's Maya. Like that, now this Bhagavan becomes a small statue and hops into Bhanudasa's bag. And they are now coming to Pandharpur. As he is coming to Pandharpur, now the entire city, the entire place of Pandharpur, they were waiting anxiously for Bhanudasa to return. And when they see Bhanudasa is coming, they know that the Lord is with him, because Bhanudasa was so sure that he wouldn't return without Panduranga. Seeing Bhanudasa's joyous face itself, all these sons, they know for sure that Panduranga has also come with him. Now the entire city now reverberates again with joy and jayakaram, and they all sing, how dhanyam, how blessed this land of Pandharpur is to have our Lord as Panduranga. How blessed is this Nagaram, because this is the Sakshat Vaikuntha. This is the place where Panduranga himself is dancing. How blessed is this Chandrabhaga? How blessed is this Venunada that we hear? How blessed is this Padmalaya Kshetra? Because all these places have the presence of the very Lord of Vaikuntha itself, Panduranga. Dhanya dhanya he nagara,
dhanya dhanya he nagara.
Lord who came back along with Bhanudas Maharaj. So it was Bhanudas Maharaj who brought the very Lord back to Pandharpur. So this was a case when we started with the phrase that if Muhammad can't go to the mountain must come to Muhammad. Here I think we can rephrase it as, here is a Mahatma who brought back the mountain, the mountain is king, back to Pandharpur. Now, there were also instances where in the case where a Mahatma couldn't go to this mountain, this mountain had gone to the Mahatma. And this is the story of Tukaram Maharaj. Such an ardent devotee of Panduranga he was. Tukaram Maharaj took the vari not once or twice a year. He used to walk to Pandharipuram from his hometown Dehu by foot on every Ekadashi day. He would take 7 days to go by foot from Dehu Grama to Pandharipuram. He would stay there for 1 to 3 days and then he would return back to Dehu another 7 days. All this while chanting Bhagavan Nama or singing his Abhangs. So this happened. So this is like half a month. This would 7 days for going to Pandharpur, staying there for 1 to 3 days and then returning, which is again 7 days. So half a month he is on his foot to Pandharpur. And this happened for 3 years. 3 years consecutively, continuously, he was able to go to Pandharpur, have Lord Darshan and come back. One Ashadi day, it so happened that this Mahatma was having high fever. He was having such a high fever that he wasn't in a position to even budge a bit. So he couldn't go to Pandharpur. And when all the varis were going, what he did out of his sorrow, he was so sad that he couldn't go to Pandharpur, that he sent something precious to the Lord from him. What would Tukaram Maharaj send? Did he have money? No. Did he have jewels? No. And these are not precious things to Tukaram Maharaj. What was precious to him? It was the Abhang itself. And therefore, Tukaram Maharaj sent 20 Abhangas to Bhagavan through these varis. And all these 20 Abhangs are so sweet Abhangs, an imploration, an open invitation to Panduranga. Oh Panduranga, wouldn't you come to give me your darshan? Look at me, I'm not able to even take one step ahead. Wouldn't you come to take care of me? I don't even ask you to take care of me. No, I just asked for your darshan. Wouldn't you give me that? Because on all Ekadashi days, Tukaram Maharaj had done so much of Harikirtan. And Tukaram Maharaj himself has sung the glory of Ekadashi day in a lot of his abhangs. He has sung, Kanthi Mirava Tulashi Vrata Kara Ekadashi Amhi Tene Sukhe Vithala Vithala Mukhi. This is the advice that Tukaram Maharaj had given to King Shivaji. If you want to make me happy, don't give me anything of gold or silver. Shivaji Maharaj gives him 2 plates full of silver coins, gold coins. Tukaram Maharaj says, this is nothing to me. Don't even bring it in front of me. If you want to make me happy, wear a tulsi bead, wear a tulsi mala. Kanthi Mirava Tulashi Vratakara Ekadashi, and undertake the Vrata of Ekadashi. Amhi Tene Sukhi. If you want to make me happy, Mana Vithala Vithala Mukhi. Chant the names of Vithala with your mouth. That alone is enough for me. Nothing else do I seek. In another abhang, it's a rather fierce abhang, where he says, he who doesn't observe the vrata of Ekadashi, he doesn't belong to the species of humans. He is like a zombie. He belongs to the land of pretas. He says, Tukaram Maharaj says, Jaya nahi neem Ekadashi vrat janave te pret shavaloki. Jaya nahi neem Ekadashi vrat. So this is the pivotal importance that all the saints of our land had given to the day of Ekadashi. But for this Ekadashi, it so happened that Tukaram Maharaj was down with malaria and he couldn't go to see his own Vithal. And when bhaktas go to Bhagavan, they do bhakti. When bhaktas can't go to Bhagavan, they do even stronger bhakti. No, when Tyagaraja Swami was also similarly pining to have darshan of Lord, he goes to the extent of scolding Lord. Not only Lord, he also scolds all his helpers, all the assistants there. He asks, Tyagaraja Swami is asking, Bhagavan, aren't your assistants as effective as they used to be before? Isn't it the duty of all those around you to remind you that there is a bhakta like this craving for your darshan? You should be going there. Earlier they used to tell that, right? Aren't they not doing their duty properly? Say, ask Tyagaraja Swami. Oh, is it because your driver isn't as efficient as he was before? Who's the Lord's driver? Garuda. So Tyagaraja Swami is asking, is he complaining that the distance from Vaikuntha to Bhumi is too much that he can't anymore flap his wings? Is that why, oh Lord, you're not coming to me? Ask Tyagaraja. Nagaraja. Yeah. all bhaktas can put their blame on Garuda Bhagavan, I think. Because like Tyagaraja Swami was asking Bhagavan, isn't your driver not as efficient as he was before? Now Tukaram Maharaj also asks, can't you come fast to me? Can't you come to see this devotee who's pining to see you, O Maharaj, O Bhagavan? And unable to withstand this, Lord Panduranga sends his driver to Tukaram Maharaj. Now the mountain is sending his own vehicle to this Mahatma, asking, instructing Garuda to take Tukaram Maharaj and come back to Pandharpur. So Garuda now comes flapping his wings. He comes to Dekhu. He comes and stands right in front of Tukaram Maharaj and asks him to get on top so that I can take you back to Pandharpur, says Garuda Bhagavan. Now Tukaram Maharaj says, this is the vehicle of my very Bhagavan. How can I, a Pamara like me, how can I sit on Garuda? Because this is where the Bhagavan himself sits. I do not consider myself fit enough, eligible enough to be sitting there. And therefore, O Garuda Bhagavan, I do not have the right to sit on you. So please ask Panduranga to come to me. And out of this comes an abhang with a lot of dhira bhavam in it. We say there are no rules in love and war, right? Therefore, in the love between the bhakta and the Bhagavan, there are absolutely no rules. So the bhakta sometimes cries out of happiness. Bhakta gets angry at Bhagavan. Sometimes the abhangs have a dhira bhava in it. Sometimes they are so sarcastic in nature. Everything is fair in love. So here, Tukaram Maharaj sings an abhang to Bhagavan, asking him, Dei dole bheti nadhari sankocha naghali kahi vecha tujhavari. O Lord, what do you lose by giving me darshan? He's asking. Does it cost you anything to come here? Does it cost me anything? Does it cost you anything? If so, you take my word for it. Don't be scared. If you come in front of me, I will have a long list of things, to-dos that I want you to do. No, I am not of that kind. Don't worry. I am just asking for your darshan. What is taking you so long to give me that? Asked Tukaram Maharaj. Tujhe budhavaave aisa ko na dharma ahanishi naam kheta thodi. Or are you thinking what worth I have so that you should come here? Is this what is going through in your mind? Well, let me remind you. Aharnishi nama gheta thode. I am chanting your names forever. I have every right to demand for your darshan, he says. Far thode kahi karuni patale tyacha madhye kal kade laavu. Let me tell you something. I will need to definitely live through my life. Just if I see you, don't think I will put all my responsibilities onto you and say, now the burden is yours. No, I won't do that. All what I have to do, I will do it myself. I won't transfer any of my duties to you, Bhagavan. Don't be scared. Don't be threatened. How can you be so naive? You are the Lord of the universe. How can anyone scare you? How can anyone even threaten you with anything? Therefore, O Bhagavan, won't you come to me? Won't you give my darshan? He sings. Ahe ma jite chi sari nasi dori bharatu javari nindhi ma jha tuka mhane amhale karachi jati tuka mhane amhale karachi jati bhetavaya khanti vatat se. Tukaram Maharaj asking, after all, Bhagavan, what am I asking to you? I'm just asking for your darshan. Am I not your child? Isn't it the right of any child to have darshan of his own parents, to be with his or her parents? Isn't that the right of any child? Like that, I am craving for your darshan, oh Bhagavan. Won't you come to me? And therefore, listening to the soulful abhang, Panduranga himself comes running to Tukaram Maharaj and he gives darshan. And therefore, when Tukaram Maharaj also gave that earnest invitation to Bhagavan, when he also called Panduranga Ere, Panduranga Ere, that Lord of Pandharpur, he came to Dehu and gave his darshan to Tukaram Maharaj. We have this song.
कौन कहते कि भगवान आते नहीं, कौन कहते कि भगवान आते नहीं, तुम मीरा के जैसे बुलाते नहीं, तुम मीरा के जैसे बुलाते नहीं.
Who said the Lord wouldn't come to you? Who said the Lord wouldn't eat with you? Who said the Lord wouldn't dance to your tunes? If you do bhakti like how these devotees have done, of course Panduranga would come with you. And this Ashadi Ekadashi occasion, where many of us can just think of Lord Panduranga from our own respective places, let Panduranga come and dance on the two bricks that are there on our hearts. Let Panduranga come to us, and with that our life will attain its purnatvam. And when the Lord dances in front of us, when the Lord dances from within us, everything is his own, nothing is ours. And therefore, with this beautiful prayer that let the Lord come to us and stay with all the bhaktas right inside our hearts forever, we offer this satsang to the very Lord of Pandharpur, to all the great saints who have shown us the path of devotion. With me, supporting me on vocals, are Madhurima Rudra and Pavitra. With me on harmonium is my husband, Sri Srikant Bhagavatar. And with me on tabla is Edappally Aravind. We take this opportunity to thank Uma Akka, who is my cousin, for giving us this opportunity to do Panduranga Smaranam on this auspicious day. And let us wish that many are taken to the abode of the Lord's land with our hands, with our hands folded, with prayer and Bhagavan's Nama on our lips, with the very Lord dancing right inside our hearts. Let us all be in Pandharpur through our minds on this auspicious day.
युगे अठावी सवि ठेवरी युभावा मांगी रखमाई दिसे दिव्य शोभा कुंडली काजे भेटी पर ब्रह्म आरे भीमा हे भीमा उद्धरे जगारे देव जय देव जय देव जय देव जय पांडुरंगा हरे पांडुरंगा रखमाई वल्लभ साई जा वल्लभ पावे देव जगारे देव जय देव तुलसी माला गला करके मुनि कटी काजे पीता हनुमंत राधे देव देव धन्य
ಹಾಲಿನ ಲೋಟ ಅಂಗಣ ವಂದೀನ ಕರಣ
ಮೌಲ್ಯಾನಿ ಪವಿರ ರೂಪದುಜಿ
गुरुनाथ महाराज की
जय जय
सर्व संतनों की
जय
जय पंढरीनाथ महाराज की
जय जय
पांडुरंग हरि वासुदेव हरि पांडुरंग हरि वासुदेव हरि पांडुरंग हरि
वासुदेव हरि